As Aparna said, things are changing quite rapidly, and we still don't have access to everything that we would like to have access to. But technology does provide us access to information, communication, and, as Aparna said, we wanted to make sure that you all had the opportunity to try out different technologies that are currently available to you. Today, however, humans have been replaced with technology, and it's no
Hi, I'm Joey Garth from New Jersey Deaf News. I'd like to welcome Aparna Lele. Aparna's with New Jersey Relay and Sprint. Welcome, Aparna. So, can you tell me what the taste of technology is? Sure, Joey, I'm happy to explain what the taste of technology is and why we call it that. Sprint and the New Jersey Relay have hosted Taste of Technology events in New Jersey for the last 9 years, and we're very proud of that. These events have speakers, booths, presentations for many different populations. Deaf people, deaf-blind people, hard of hearing people, those with a hearing loss, or people with a speech disability. Taste of Technologies expose people to different technology that's available for them to use to meet whatever communication need they have. As you know, technology evolves so quickly. It's amazing how fast it changes. So these events are important to show people how technology can help them in their everyday lives. It can help people with communication access. It can help them find information. Technology really improves people's daily lives in many different ways. So the title, Taste of Technology, if you think about it like a buffet, when you're tasting a lot of different food, there may be new tastes to you. Some are sweet, some are salty, others are spicy. That is akin to what we're doing here, except instead of food, we're tasting technology. So you're able to try out different technology and empower yourself to make wise decisions on what will help you best communicate. That's great, Aparna, and it's really, really impressive to think about your clients and think about your people and let them taste or try the different technology to figure out what works best for them. I really appreciate it, and thanks so much for speaking.
Hi, I'm Joey Garth with New Jersey Deaf News. I'd like to introduce you to Catherine Gavry. Catherine is with the DeafBlind Community Access Network of New Jersey, DBCAN. Welcome. DeafBlind people in New Jersey are here today for a Taste of Technology event. Do you mind telling us about it?
My pleasure, Joey. Thank you. Our event today is sponsored by Sprint and the DeafBlind Community Access Network of New Jersey. And we're bringing people together to explore technology. Technology has been an incredible boost for folks who are deafblind. Why? It connects people to the world. Before technology, if we think about the days of Helen Keller, Helen needed an individual with her at all times in order to connect to people, to places, and to things. Today, with the advance of technology, people who are deafblind are able to connect to people, places, and things independently. They can use braille displays. They can use screen magnification to connect to the internet, to shop, to get on phone calls with their friends, to stay connected. The phone improvements have been incredible so that people who are deafblind can be out looking for a Dunkin' Donuts independently on their own. Technology has given people independence. And that's why this day is so important. People here today can visit with vendors. They can find technology that works for them. Every person who's deafblind is a little bit different. So every piece of technology is not going to work, but they can find that piece that works for them. And that's what we're here today to do. So we're thrilled that Sprint has combined efforts with DBCAN New Jersey. And we are just thrilled at the attendance. We've had great volunteer support. The community is behind us 100%. And we are so happy to be here today. Thank you, Joey.
That's awesome. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Deafblind people have a place to get together today, and they don't have to be isolated. They can come together and see what technology best works for them. So thank you so much, and thank you for watching. This has been New Jersey Deaf News.